everybody, I'm Hrvoje Kalafatić from Institute of Archaeology in Zagreb. I will present you some recent developments in Urnfield research, in laboratory work on Urnfield research in Croatia with my colleague Mislav Čavka from University Hospital Zagreb. Thank you, organizer, for organizing session and for nice session to be here. We will start just to talk about some, when I see here the Western Europe and especially Netherlands and Belgium and even Denmark, we have these urn fields, you know, you have from Bronze Age, Iron Age, Roman Age. In Central Europe we have this term strictly to the late Bronze Age mostly, so we also have urn field cemeteries before that in Middle Bronze Age, and we also have urn field cemeteries in Iron Age, but we like to talk about Urnfield cemeteries only about late Bronze Age. I will discuss this part of Southern Carpathian Basin. As you can see, it's standard, let's say, part of Central European Urnfield cultures or groups, we can call them, around the river of Sava and Drava, and you can see the Danube. And with a lot of cemeteries around, we will focus some research not just on this urn typology. We wanted to move further to see what's beyond all these typologies. Especially I worked, and my colleagues, we worked on this Barice-Gređani group, which has very uniform type of urns, which I will show now. And we, as they're all very, very fragmented, with very fragmented bones and metals, We start using CT scans 13 years ago, at the beginning as some kind of pioneers, and developing by the years also usage of magnetic resonance in our research. It's very interesting that we also have some ideas to develop. We have a lot of very, very crowded cemeteries with more than 100 burials, but none of the graves are disrupted. They're all very close, maybe even touching urns, but we found proofs of some visible marks on the graves, which are important not to destroy any older graves, as you know. And we plan to take all the grave together with this visible mark, maybe to put some in some bigger veterinary animal machine for CT scan, maybe to see difference in color of the soil, because we discovered that some parts of the soil, some clays and some sands, have different reaction and different picture on the screen, let's say, so we can distinguish them. We have two cases here, two cemeteries, one largest one of Barice-Gređani group in Mačkovac, and the new one from this year is Petrijevci near Osijek. Both are very important because this Barice-Gređani group has this special particular ritual where they have these large urns always reversed to the soil together with the bones, and Virovitica has standard ritual where you have the urn with some vessel or not on it. And of course Belgis has the same standard ritual, but we don't have any Belgish cemeteries in Eastern Croatia. And Western Serbia we have, but we'll talk that later. The important part is that Eastern Croatia here is the contact zone of all three groups, and we have mixture of different rituals on different cemeteries. In Mačkovac we have only Barice-Gređani, let's say, type of burial, but in this Petrijevci we have Virovitica and Barice-Gređani burials mixing together. When I say Barice-Gređani burial, I mean, as you can see, large urn with open lid reversed in the ground with some side woods, and this is Virovitica type of burial, also standard type, with really standard type of urn. It may differ from grave to grave with some other vessel above. We will see in Mačkovac some lowland settlement of Barice-Gređani group. It's interesting that we found two cemeteries in a lot of years of excavating and researching a wider area. So that's discussion, because we have this standard settlement, as you can see, divided by some water riverbed with cemetery, and we have also last years found also this cemetery together with settlement. I think the solution is they didn't have dead together with them in the settlement. I think it's just later cemetery for some reason made there, maybe after the end of this settlement or whatever, but it really is connected. And we can see that graves on cemetery 2 are younger and later than the pits around. We can see that by stratigraphic positions of the graves. As you can see, we have this problem of fragility of the urns. It's very bad preserved. The only way, and the best way to take them out is to document all, to take all the soil and to have it in folio or some, to take it all to laboratory for some other work and research. In this case, we didn't do that. As you can see, it's standard also, reverse urn with some side goods, but this urn we were never able to fix it again, to restore it, because it's so, we thought it if we take every part, if we take pictures of it, but it's still half missing, because it's just very, very collapsed. They are very dense, of the graves is very, as you can see, the graves are very dense on the Mačkovac. This is some standard type of urns. After we take them out and restore them, you will see our process. This is sometimes 9 or 10 types of the urns, but this first six types of urn can be, I would say, one type. It's only a modification of one same type with open lid. As you can see, it's standard type of shape of vessel used even today everywhere. Some pictures from Eastern Croatia, some from Zagreb, but I also find some in Western Europe, Amsterdam. I'm collecting now today, so it's a really standard. Maybe it's the longest way. You can have some regular pot from the beginning of prehistory until today is the same, and this type of vessel is probably also the same. This type of vessel are existing even in early Bronze Age, from early Bronze Age on. So it's probably very useful for work. As you know, we started use 2006 the radiology. Paleoradiology has started immediately after inventing of radiology from 1869 till today. Even the first usage of radiology in archaeology, one of the first was our scientist Goranović Kramberger, who made these first radiology pictures of Krapina Neanderthals. In as you can see, in the end of 20th century we have CT, and then in 21st century magnet resonance. When we started in 2006, we just made some Rengen pictures, but the clay soil in the urns was so hard, and so we didn't get any of the results with the standard Rengen. So we decided to use standard Siemens computed tomography machine of newest generations, and we used these slices of 1.2 millimeters. We tried even 0.2, 0.5, and many different types, but we decided this is the best for us. You will see why. So also this is how it goes. Let's say some research procedure. We excavate. This is the drawing of the urn, and this is a restored urn. We need this because of, you will see, we didn't know for many years this ritual of putting the burned bones in the pit and then covering with the reversed urn. It was for 50 years main theory, but as you can see on CT scan, all the bones are inside of the end of the urn, and all pictures show that bones are always, you don't see the much of the lid now, but they're also on the top, on the bottom of the reverse urn. The other very important part for us, as you saw with Matija in Denmark, that we can see the metal, and the reason is why it's important to see metal. This metal is burned together on the funeral pyre with human body, and very, very fragile. If you don't know it before, it will collapse and disappear. We had such situations before 2008, so we decided to take picture of every grave, as you can see. This is the same situation, some graves with the bones together. They were probably put together in some organic material and not thrown in the pit and covered by the reverse urn. This is, as you can see, also some metals. This is probably child grade. We don't have final anthropological results, but for my in our research experience, smaller urns are belonging to children, and smaller urns are also the important for the that they have more metal. As you can see, there is some feather here and needle together, so it's still unopened and waiting for some next generation of CT scanners. We can wait. I think it's we just measure humidity of the urn and we think it's stable here and it can wait for some better results. So the reason I told you the disease was on the funeral pyre of oak, the fire was made by oak tree, so high temperatures are involved, and we had some problems connecting with this dry clay. The even CT scan couldn't reach a good we couldn't get good visibility of all these bones between bones and clay here in the urn. So we tried one new method, I mean new sequence of magnetic resonance, because to see we got the bones, but the problem was with magnetic resonance on the funeral pyre, you lost all water in the bones and you can't see the bones anymore. That's the way how it, magnetic resonance works. It do something with molecule of water and then shows the picture. But last year Siemens together with us developed some new sequence for the machine. It's important to them to work with us, or, I mean to work with human bones and human material, because you know at least they say it's okay for ethical reasons, because it's much longer program of making a picture. It's a few hours, so any living person couldn't stand so much of let's say some kind of adjusting. And now we have this new type of software included in all this UTE sequence, is standard sequence of all magnet resonance machines of Siemens. In some way we also have this new generation of magnetic resonance machines in Croatia, but still waiting for our turn to have these pictures of Petric cemetery we excavated this year. Much more of metal objects survives now in our research. This is the cemetery in Adron Petrievci on the contact zone between Barice-Gređani, Belegiš and Virovitica. As you can see, we have some preliminary results. This is excavated last month. It was much easier to do it this one because procedure is much quicker, because after CT there is some kind of small metal, so we can't go to magnetic resonance because of that. But we still can see, as you can see, it's much better visibility now. It's, I think we develop our methods on the heaviest type of soil in Mačkovac. Now it's much easier for us to work and to see. We discussed about can you measure or not bones in anthropological research. You can. It's good because it is not so bad, because it, most of these bones, as you can see on the research of Matija Črešnar and colleagues, it's fragmented after you open the urn. But it's a lot of work, and I think it's month of measuring of every urn to do anything close for and good for anthropological research. The other thing I just wanted to shortly mention is this type of marks here, and we plan to take all the, when we find out all the pieces of soil together, I think we will be able now with new generation of machines to see the even these dots, or those, I mean these marks are visible. They are not the same type of the soil like cemeteries, so it's not just some urns here or there. Really, there is much more story around it, not just urns, but around all the stuff together. And now I can in the end call you to our some kind of workshop. It will be held in Zagreb in autumn for 4 days. There is two levels of it. There is some parallel radiology workshop, not just Urnfields, but also medieval graves, also some mummies, Egyptian mummies, we like to work on mummies with Swiss colleagues also. Zagreb has a large collection of Egyptian mummies, so also developing some methods. And we are also organizing some small conference concerning paleoradiology meets archaeology. It's the second one. Every 2 years we have conference, you're all invited. There is some fee for the first workshop, and for the other one it's completely free, so you're all invited. Thank you for your attention.